look at the power of the PlayStation 5 Pro, man. Oh, my God.
Like, it's here.
Whoa.
Without the blurred edges that are characteristic of regular ops.
Bro, look at the lighting. What?
Yeah, this man is definitely on Sony's payroll after this, bro. And the funny thing is, Digital Foundry is comparing the Pro mode to PS5's performance mode, which I'm assuming is performance and the high fidelity mode in one package. You guys probably wondering as to what I think. Is this really worth paying $700? Because if you still got a trash TV, then more likely it's going to look like the comparison on the left side of the corner. Okay? You people are doing too much, man. Like, this is what happens when PlayStation fanboys got caught in these little hardware sales and forgot the main aspect of a console, which is to purchase and play new games. I mean, if this is what Sony's doing to y'all, man, this has got to be some of the most anti-consumer and lazy practices that I have ever seen from any company, even more so than Nintendo. And that's saying a lot.
Oh, my God.
Bro, oh, my God. Look at the well, man.
On the left.
Oh.
It just looks fuzzy. Like, you, bro, look at the lighting on the Pro. Like, you can make out the individual.
Oh.
Lighting. Oh, man. This is
I can't wait to play my PS4 games on my PlayStation 5 Pro. Oh, my God.
Touch. Man.
Man, out here sounding like Amazing Lucas.
The obvious edge, though, comes down to the way the game's alpha-tested foliage resolves. The game's old foliage had a...
And you know what this also means? That the PS5 console that you guys got was severely underpowered. If you guys are going to mention these things now. Okay, look at the grass, the foliage. Oh, it looks so much better. But you people have to understand that Digital Foundry is comparing it to the PS5's performance mode. I can guarantee you when the game runs at its high fidelity mode, you're probably seeing the same difference. The Pro mode is combining the two features into one package to where you don't have to essentially compromise your gaming experience. Now you guys are understanding this is PS5's performance mode against PlayStation 5's high fidelity mode at a more stable 60. That's what we're seeing right now. So of course we're going to see the difference, bro. Like it says it at the top left corner, PS5 performance mode. We already knew that performance mode, they lower the resolution so they can keep a more stable frame rate. We know that. So why didn't Digital Foundry, I don't know if they did, but why didn't they not compare it to its high fidelity mode to PS5 Pro's high fidelity mode? You would not see no difference.
A rough appearance range and
Yep. Needed
to look coarser in general.
Yep.
Even at a closer distance to the camera.
Yep.
PSVR is doing a better job.
These ponies will do anything to defend this platform, man. It's quite sad to be honest with you.
Of resolving these elements. And it looks like the art may have been tweaked to help accommodate this as well. Image detail at rest is improved quite a lot overall. The extent that matters depends on how you choose to play this.
Wow.
Whether you view the game at close range or not.
Crazy, man. This dude out here paying for snowflakes, bro, on character models' jackets, bro. Like, I'm sorry, man. You know, I kind of regret picking up a PS5, man. It's very hurtful to see that you people is out here damage controlling for snowflakes on snow jackets, right? All because the PS5 Pro got no games, man. Oh, games! This is a game. Come on, this is a PS4 game, bro. Cut it out, man. Like I said, the game was good. It's probably one of the best looking PS4 games that we've had made. But come on, man. You guys are running low demanding games, and these are the type of improvements that you guys got to be that negligible? Man, I was expecting to see a whole difference, especially if you're talking about $700 to $800.
Image clarity differences are awesome.
Bro, on the Pro, it's so smooth.
You know it's the same game. What are you talking about, bro? The game's 60 FPS. You see, now PlayStation fanboys are being exposed. All the PS5 Pro did was expose every single narrative that these PlayStation fanboys had. What do you mean smooth? I thought the original was already 60 FPS. So essentially what you're saying, that the PS5 version of this game wasn't 60 FPS? Or was it stable enough for you ponies to play it? So all this shilling, all this damage controlling y'all did for PlayStation about how we got 4K 60 wasn't fully realized until the Pro came out? So all y'all been doing was capping for the past 2 to 3 years?
Oh my, I gotta replay Last of Us now. I have to replay. Bro, this runs so smooth on the Pro. Like, let's go
whether
back.
You view the game at close range on a monitor.
God dang, that's butter.
Are often more apparent, or at a far distance on a TV. but sometimes they can seem more subdued. One issue that is quite apparent to all younger
age. And remember, guys, this is a PS4 game.
So, is image breakup, as flickering on high contrast edges tends to catch the eye, even if a slight softness throughout the frame is harder to perceive. Here, the Pro delivers pretty solid results. Pushing forward through the scene tends to.
Look at the performance mode on the base PS5. Look at the
look at the high fidelity mode right in the middle. It looks the same. See, this is what I was trying to tell you. The PS5 Pro mode is essentially fidelity and performance mode all in one. That's what you're not understanding. The performance mode looks ugly, so I don't know how you people have been playing performance mode games on PS5. I told people, go for the high quality mode, man. High fidelity, because just to me, honest, it's not the better performance is not that, it's not worth that much of a visual downgrade. I mean, that on the left corner, it's looking like an N64 game, okay? Like, it's actually looking quite bad. But when you look at the middle and you look at the pro mode, it looks reasonable. It looks quite good. So this is why I'm trying to tell you that games need to be capped at 30 frames per second so we can start seeing some more graphically demanding games. Because honestly, we're not going to be able to achieve that with 60. And you're not going to be able to get that for even the PS5 Pro unless it's a remaster or a remake. I mean, but if you really look at fidelity mode and pro mode, they look entirely the same. I'm looking at it right now, and you was out here damage controlling for this. Yes, the PS5 performance mode looks bad in comparison to the pro mode. We can see that, but not PS5's fidelity mode, which is more likely what most people would have played the game on. Not Mr. PS5 N64 performance mode.
Dude right here, you can barely make out his face. I mean, this is no lie. You can see it
right. And what happened to the days where you guys say that every game need a performance mode? Why would Microsoft drop games without a performance mode? And yet they did it for Until Dawn Remake. And yet you didn't even bring that up in your review, right? Shouldn't they have delayed the game to have a performance mode? But that game has way more problems than just a performance mode. It has bugs and crashes, and the game is virtually unplayable. Okay? So this is what we're trying to tell you, man. I'm just wondering what the next narrative is going to be. Right after Until Dawn Remake being capped at 30, because that game did not come with a. Remember, Xbox make broken games. They made one. Also, Xbox makes 30 frames per second games. Sony has made one on Unreal Engine 5, which happens to be a remake to a PS4 game. So, what is the narrative now? What is the narrative? No performance mode option. Shouldn't that game have been delayed at a later date if Sony can't get it together, if they can't put a 60 frames per? And what's even more funny, Starfield has it now, and Until Dawn does it. This is ridiculous, bro. All you ponies do is change the narrative, bro. That's all y'all do.
In front of your eyes, the base PS5 performance mode look fuzzy. Fidelity mode on the base PS5, you can make out his face more. And then on the Pro, it just looks a bit sharper and more crisp.
Resolving fine detail than the old PSA, like with these metal bars. Sometimes it does look just a touch sharp, though, to my eyes, which wouldn't be that noticeable on a TV screen. But
That's exactly what I was saying. So if you have a good television, you won't even notice most of these differences, bro.
Sometimes looks slightly unnatural in close-ups.
Mm-hmm.
One rare exception can come down to water rendering.
Wow, we out here comparing snowflakes, bro. I don't even know what's wrong with the game.
With a fast-moving stream here.
You know PC gamers are laughing at you guys, right? You know, I understand that it doesn't matter what other people say, but you know PC gamers are laughing at you because you guys are paying $700 and $800 for snowflakes on jackets, just so the game can look about the same on the PS5 base model.
First, with a little bit of additional blur across the water surface, with a softer riverbed below. Here, the performance mode in Pro delivers similar results, with the fidelity mode.
Look at the water! Look at this ugly water!
He just said that it has similar results, and yet you was out here bashing. See, this is what, you see how these ponies operate? So you're trying to say anybody that has the old PS5, we got scammed, we got bamboozled? You're getting bamboozled with the Pro, because honestly, that $700 price tag that y'all people paying for is not worth the differences that I'm seeing. I'm sorry, bro. I'm gonna break it down to you. It is what it is,
bro. Are y'all seeing this?
Now all of a sudden, PS5 games look bad.
See now, look how the water looked so choppy on the PS.
You know what, man? You put this. This is why I try to tell you that consoles will cease to exist, because look at the type of behavior that you guys are doing. You people can't even enjoy the game anymore. Y'all comparing textures, and this is funny because I've heard from PC gamers alike, and they told me, man, they said, yo, I had to get off that whole graphics card, man. You know what I mean? I had to get off that with, you know, upgrading my PCs and all that, because you know what he told me? This is an honest story from a PC gamer, that he got so caught up in doing that he forgot the whole purpose of why he got the PC in the first place, which is to play games. You get what I'm saying? What comes great power comes great responsibility, and sometimes you have to be happy and fulfilled with what you have and play what you own currently. You get what I mean? Well, I mean, ponies are doing that anyway. But still, what I'm trying to say, that you got to appreciate the visual quality and the performance modes or whatever you guys are getting, okay? Because you guys are going to be so caught up in, look, oh, look at the little visuals. Look at the little textures. I mean, we're now finally going back to the days of the 360 and PS3. But at least with those consoles, there was actually differences. It's like, y'all remember when NBA 2K6 and NBA Live 06 came out, everybody was talking about the sweat. Oh my God, look at the sweat. It's dripping off his face. And, you know, that's what everybody was talking about, man. You know what I mean? They were talking about sweat in these basketball games. But I will say there was a noticeable difference between the PS2 and the PS3 games. But we're not seeing that, man. Not for this $700 upgrade, you know?
It's PS5 in fidelity mode. Get that 30 FPS garbage out of here. Look at that.
You hear that? 30 FPS garbage. Well, I guess Until Dawn remake was trash, but yet you finished the game anyway because Sony paid you through a review code.
Modern Pro delivers similar results, with the fidelity mode appearing substantially sharper. Moving transparencies like this often suffer a bit with reconstruction, though the results here look fine enough, I'd say.
Wow.
Image stability is somewhat fixed. Head-to-heads in most scenes reveal the...
I don't see the difference. PS5 fidelity mode and PS5 Pro mode, I don't really see that difference that you was talking about.
Distant and temporally stable image from a normal viewing distance. There is a bit of a trend on Pro to resolve a bit more image detail while also suffering from extra image breakup. Mm-hmm. For instance...
They got PS5 Pro, got image breakup. What do you think about that? Wow! Are you going to say, oh my goodness, with that?
These strings...
Let's hear it. Look at that. I see his eye roll. He's like, uh-oh. Go ahead, talk about it.
Flicker lightly in and out of view while the Pro resolves...
Oh, now you don't want to talk about it, huh? You don't want to be excited no more?
Lines that have a tendency to...
Look at this fool, bro. I can't stand this fool, man.
The Pro definitely delivers clearer foliage rendering, but we do see obvious breakup.
He looks so stupid. Damage controller for this, and they talk about it got more image breakup.
Seems somewhat characteristic of PSSR. Some scenes, like this walking shot in Jackson, expose substantially more breakup than Pro.
What you gonna say about that, Marlon? What you gonna say? Go ahead, say something.
In typical play, though, I think both options are doing a good enough job for console play. Most of the underlying visual settings on PS5 Pro, though...
Yo, John Littleman hurt his feelings. Look at this.
This seems pretty common on PS5 Pro 60 FPS modes.
This is the super special spectral resolution Sony was talking about, because I clearly don't see it.
Doesn't affect the visuals much at all here, actually, because those settings are nearly identical to begin with.
It's identical! He ain't gonna make it out the hood with this one, man. He told you it's practically identical. And I said that at the beginning of this video, guys, that all it does is look like it's on fidelity mode. You know, you was out here comparing the Pro version to PS5's performance mode. Of course it's gonna look better, you big dummy. Come on,
certain
man.
Certain rare instances, this we dude. Can observe a bit of popping that isn't present in the fidelity
mode. Look at that choppy mess.
In this cutscene...
Look at that choppy...
PlayStation gamers don't even have appreciation for their own console. They do this all the time, bro. Y'all don't even appreciate the PS4 anymore, bro. That's all Sony dudes do. They move on to the next console and even bash their own platform. The same platform that they said was godlike. The same platform they said was better than Xbox. But then they go as far to bash it just so they can cap for something else. It's sad.
Pay attention to the middle. You see that choppy mess? Oh, God.
The performance mode and Pro deliver identical results.
It wasn't choppy when you guys was comparing it to Xbox games, right?
In this shot, where I was able to engineer just the slightest bit of pop-in on Pro and the performance mode,
jeez,
but not the fidelity mode. I really have to go out of my way here, as this is extremely challenging to spot in almost all of my comparison footage.
John Linneman got to make sure he ain't putting the wrong footage in the wrong category, bro. He's essentially telling you that there's really no difference with this game.
Any other visual change of note that is evident generally here comes down to depth of field, which is deeper than either PS5.
Choppy mess.
The performance mode and fidelity mode are close to equally shallow, with the Pro looking substantially deeper.
Wow.
The depth of field in the fidelity mode and the Pro appears to count at the same 1080p resolution, but the upsampling process to 4K may be decreasing that blurring effect.
Whoa, on some occasions, look at her arm, bro. Yes. See what I'm saying? Upscaling it to 4K image, bro. This is exactly...
And you know what's crazy? It's not even native 4K. We should be playing this game at native 4K on the Pro. We shouldn't even be playing it at upscaled 4K? Come on, bro.
What's going to happen with GTA 6? GTA 6, for all we know, might run at 1080p, 60...
You guys are like wild games. So it's like, I know you want to say something. Did you just say that GTA 6 is going to run at 1080p 60? 1080p 60. Hold on, let's rewind that.
That's exactly what's going to happen with GTA 6. GTA 6, for all we know, might run at 1080p 60 with upscale image to 4K. I'm telling
you. Oh my God, bro. You ponies have lost it, bro. Y'all are just delusional, bro. There's no saving you no more. You don't want to be saved. Don't save him. He don't want to be saved. Don't save him. He don't want to be saved. What is you talking about, bruh? Like, I got to pull out J. Cole for you, man. What are you doing? GTA 6, 1080p, 60? You got to be kidding me, man. And this is why people laugh at y'all. It ain't because the PS5, well, it is bad in my opinion, but... Like I said, it's because y'all say irrational things like this. GTA 6, 1080p 60. You can't even get Until Dawn Remake at 1080p 60. What makes you think you're going to get an open world game as ambitious as Grand Theft Auto 6? Bruh, I don't want to hear it.
I'm telling you, right now, prepare yourself. You know what I'm saying? Prepare yourself. That might very well, or it might be 1440p. Or dynamic 1440p on the base PS5 and then upscale to 4K.
What? Oh my God. They really think Grand Theft Auto 6 is going to drop at 4K.
On PS5 Pro. I'm telling
you. You're a joke, bro. I'm very shocked as to how you got people that follow your channel, bro. I would have been calling you cap during this whole live stream for saying that. Like, are you serious? Where's the real gamers here, guys? Where's the real gamers? Oh, I forgot. You got to be a subscriber for 24 hours to even leave a comment on his thing. He does that on purpose because he knows that what he's saying is dumb. Y'all need to start making some more videos on him, man. Like, I really don't understand how you're going to sit there and say that GTA 6 is going to be upscale 4K, 60 frames per second, when you guys are struggling to run a remake from the PS4 generation. Y'all calling PS4 games on the PS5 blurry and fuzzy. So what do you think you're going to get with GTA 6, which happens to be an open world game? Come on, I don't even know what to say anymore.
Just looking at this, it gives me an idea.
Man, it's out here comparing arms and stuff, bro. What are you doing? Look at your arm.
Of what PSSR is going to be able to do.
PSSR ain't doing nothing.
On the PS5 Pro, you can see the hair on her arm and...
You can see the hairs on the arms, man. Like, I thought a woman ain't supposed to have hair on her arms.
On the base PS, look how ugly that looks. Look at her arm. Look how ugly.
That's performance mode.
And choppy.
That's what you guys asked for, wasn't it not? Then did you guys say, well, I don't care if the games look ugly. Microsoft should include performance mode in every single game, right? But what's more laughable is the fact that this is a PS4 game and it looked that bad. And you're complaining.
You can see it fuzzy. On the base PS5 in performance mode, fidelity looks sharp, but on the Pro, you can see it. Like I said, I have the eye to see this. This is not a reason for, like, if you have an eye for this stuff, if you are somebody that wants more out of your console and you can't afford PC, the Pro is going to be for you, bro.
No, it's not. Because at this point, you might as well go PC because you could pay $700 for a graphics card and actually notice a very drastic difference. You see, there's a difference, you know, because before you people say, well, PC's too expensive. They're like $1,000 and up. Okay, you pay $500 for a console. You pay $700 for this. You pay for subscription. You don't even get free online multiplayer. If you play on another console, that's going to boost it up to $1,800, $1,900. So look at what you guys are doing, man. You guys are spending about $2,000 and you could be doing this experience right here far better than what you're getting. And this is why PC gamers laugh at you on top of having free online multiplayer with mod support and all that. Like, I really don't understand how these ponies' logic is, man.
Like, this is just early beginnings. You can see the difference, bro.
What do you mean early beginnings? The game is already made.
Crazy.
Blurring effect. On some occasions, the intersection of in-focus and out-of-focus elements
can produce a bit same, of a healing
effect on the Pro, though this is also evident at different moments in the PS5 modes as well. There are also some issues with some things just appearing not to render correctly on the Pro. The glass...
Look at it, he gets quiet, right? Every time John Linneman talks about the PS5 Pro and how there's something wrong with that version, he gets quiet.
For grind pattern on the Pro... and the materials on the floor also appear very different. I suspect these are just bugs that will be resolved at some point.
Look, before bugs.
Release. Exactly.
PS5. Oh, exactly. Oh, so you're going to defend that version has bugs already? No different than Until Dawn Remake?
I noticed some slight differences in shadow coverage and the appearance of direct lighting in a couple of our test scenes here, and I think these are unintended as well.
Man.
Unbelievable.
Perhaps the most interesting point of comparison
for Sony's
upsampling solution.
The damage controller, bro. I had enough of this, man. But like I said, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, man. The PS5 Pro clearly ain't worth the $700. Stick to your base PS5s. The end.